I first became interested in magic when I was 14. That's when I first started learning magic. But it was when I first saw David Blaine actually perform. That's where when I first became inspired, I thought I need to know how to do that. So that's when I started reading books and studying. But it wasn't until actually I left university that I decided I wanted to become a magician. So I just started swatting and learning and learning, and within a couple of years I was performing and doing it as my full-time job. So that's how it all kind of started out for me. A special gift? I don't know. I've also always gravitated towards anything to do with human behaviour. So all the subjects I've studied has been psychology, sociology, and social psychology. And so I say after performing as a magician for 6, 7 years, I then decided I wanted to combine both of these things. And so that's what I've been doing for the past sort of 5 years or so, and just seeing the kind of results you can get, which has been fascinating for me. I think there are a number of reasons why this show is different. First and foremost, I'm a female doing it, and actually, I'm proud to say I'm the first ever female to have her own magic TV show, which is very exciting. And so that's massive. It's a massive difference. And in the series, it's great because that gives me the opportunity to go into different areas which other magicians wouldn't go into, sort of like a pregnancy yoga class, for example. You wouldn't find your average magician in an environment like that. So that's a major difference. Also, the fact that I'm dealing with everything, everyday with psychology, that's what I'm dealing with, and everyday people. So I really wanted to combine both of these things, and I think that really resonates with people. When you're going up to random people in the street and telling them personal information about themselves, just walking up to people, talking to them about personal information about themselves, then it really resonates with people, and I think that really stays with them, and it has massive impact. And you can see that. There's no actors, no stooges in the show, and the audience get to see that. So I think that's quite a different experience. People's reactions are big, and as I said, because it's so personal to them, if you have someone showing you something impossible to inanimate objects outside of yourself, that's one thing. But if you have someone telling you personal information about yourself, thoughts that you're having in that moment, that has an effect on people, of course, because it's very personal to them. So, it can be any kind of reaction, really. It could be anything from, someone getting emotional, depending on what it's to do with. It could be someone being stunned to silence. Sometimes you get people just kind of freaked out. They don't know how to respond. But, overall, I wanted it to be a positive experience and something that they remember. And in that moment, they feel affected by it. That's what I want, what I aim for. I think this show has a huge appeal worldwide. First of all, because I think, being a female and no one's seen that before, it's something different. And I think it's interesting for people seeing something that they've never seen before. I also think because I've been really conscious that I wanted to include as many different types of people as possible. So I've had people involved which are elderly couple that have been married for 40 years, or children as young as 6, and everyone in between, in all different situations, everyday situations, in a supermarket where everyone goes. And I'll talk about how we think we've got a free choice, but actually we don't. So all of these things relate to anybody, whoever you are. We've all got grandparents, we've got sisters, brothers, mums and dads, so we can all relate to it when we watch it. And that's what I think that I think for that reason it has huge appeal. One of my favourite items from the show, I wanted to become almost like a human lie detector. So I wanted to go somewhere and see if I could crack a code to a safe. But it was important for me that there was some sense of jeopardy. So I went to a high-end jeweller's on New Bond Street, so very expensive jewellers. I went in there, I spoke to the shop assistant, and I said, "I'd like to play a game with you. If you're okay with it, and I want to attempt to crack the code to your safe. But beforehand, play this game with me. I'm going to ask you questions. It's important that you lie to every single question I ask you." And so she did. She lied and lied and lied. And after about 5 minutes, I was able to sort of ascertain how she lied, her micro expressions, pick up on nuances. And once I had a baseline for that, I then asked her again to keep lying to me, but to tell me a false code to the safe. And I told her to take me to the safe, and I had a crack at opening it, but I won't give it away.